What's up, guys? My name is Krista Baldwin. I'm taking you through a day in the life of a top fuel driver, and that's me. I'm a top fuel driver. Last night we had Friday night qualifying. First run, we went out there on a planned shutoff, and everything looked good. We came back. Unfortunately, I pulled the main stud, so we had to switch motors, and we just didn't have enough time to get back up there for Q2. But we are ready to go for Q3 and Q4 today. I really want to run like a low to mid 80 just to get into the show. This is going to be a super, super stout field. 21 cars here, and a lot of the part-time teams are cars that run in the 370s. So I hope everything that I've done over the last month with me and my team and upgrading all my parts works for us. But I guess we'll find out. We're going to go so fast.
Go ahead.
Anything to say?
Get out of my way.
Dude, they took us on a sailboat ride
yesterday. Okay, guys, it's the end of the weekend. I am actually back in Brownsburg, Indiana, in my office at Paul Lee Racing. I accidentally forgot to vlog some of my runs, so I figured I'd come back here, go to my handy dandy NHRA.tv, and we're going to analyze each run as it happens. And so you guys will get an in-depth perspective of what happens on each run. So obviously, not exactly the weekend we were looking for without getting qualified, but I came home with fresh parts. And nothing was broken, or nothing major was broken, and I'm able to race another day. So let's start with Q1. All right, here we go. Q1, burnout number one of the weekend. Is it ever too much for me to say that doing a burnout in a top fuel car is absolutely amazing? I mean, you hit the gas and you go off on the tire. The sound, the noise, the vibration of the car, and just starting, knowing that you're gonna make a run. It's so much fun. Yes, and huge thanks to IGTG, Breen Engineering, and Mainline Sales for coming on board with me this weekend. If it weren't for you, I would not have been able to be half as successful as I was this weekend. Throttle stops coming off. They're checking the idle. They're charging the cannon, and I'm gonna move forward. Ooh, man, what a great shot of that glitter injector. Man, I just love it. I hope you guys think it's not too much, but I like it. All right, here we go. Look at that grandpa right there. All right, fuel on, clutch out. Here we go. Okay, so it left the starting line pretty nice. It was a little lazy, about 915, 60 foot. But the plan was always going to be a half track run. So 915, 60 foot, and then 2.31 seconds at the 330. And then from the 60 foot to the 330, I had a hole go out, and that's why it's a little soft. But obviously, that's what we needed. We just needed that checkout run.
How hard do you think it was for Krista to roll off the throttle? And
yes, Joe is so right. It is so hard all the time when you have a planned shutoff that you want to keep going, but you know you have to shut it off just to save those parts and pieces for the next round. So after we went to Q1, we went back, we did normal service on the motor, and we saw that we actually stripped a main stud. And so, unfortunately, I had to switch motors, and we swapped motors pretty quickly. We were trying our hardest to go back up there for Q2 for that nighttime session. Like, I knew that we were going to go run really, really hard on that nighttime one, but I needed like 10 to 15 more minutes in my pit to make sure that everything we put together was correct. And when we spun it over, it was not. So we had to do a couple of fixes on there. But you know what? It was okay because it made me more confident for Saturday. We were able to put the car away early. We were able to, you know, regroup and figure out what we want to do on the next run. Man, I love doing a burnout. Remember, guys, I don't have a transmission in this car. It is a direct drive, so I can only go forward and reverse, and that is it. The clutch is centrifugal. Obviously, it's like driving a manual car. You shove the clutch in, the car's in neutral, they bring it out, and the car's going to start to roll. Look at Grandpa. How about my chick, Katie Butera, is backing me up in cheetah print shorts? And if we're going to do something, we're going to do it right. Like I said, this is going to be a half-track run. We changed the blocks, just wanted to make sure everything was all good on the run, because I wanted to come back and make another run later that night, not blow up something. Full-time here in the NHRA. Right now, she's not qualified. 3.900 is Kyle Wurzel's number. Get inside that if you want to have a chance of being in the field. That was a beautiful run, you guys. I hope you guys can see the early numbers on that. 875, 223, 252. Shoot, I really did not want to lift on that one. She's trying to make the field. Something may have happened right there, or was that a planned shutoff? Do you know?
She's got to turn it up if things ain't going right. So I give her credit for that.
So how cool is it to come out to the race?
Our grandpa's so cute. Look at this run. Oh, God, I hiked the front end up. It was going. It was charging. Here comes the clutch. And here comes my foot coming off the throttle. Believe me, it pains me as much as you watching this, me stepping off the car, the gas. I wanted to go so bad to the finish line on that one. Would I have made it to the 390 bump? Maybe. That was on track to be like a 389 to a 392 run, so obviously early numbers were great. We're going to go back to the pit, we're going to do our normal service, and then we're going to come up to Q4 and throw whatever we got to it. Alright, Q4 time. I literally just watched Joe Morrison run a 393. Did not make it. Right in front of me. Literally right in front of me. So what is going through my head right now? One, I'm a race car driver, so I want to go really, really fast right now. Two, I hope that we make it in the field. Three, I hope I don't blow anything up. A lot of anxiousness in this moment right now. And I'm just so excited to hit the gas, and the unknown is just so big right now.
Leopard print. You know, Krista can get away with a leopard print like Antron can.
I would love to see Antron in some cheetah leopard print action. Come on, Antron. I know you got it in you. This is it. Pulling forward into the beams. Are we going to make it? Are we not going to make it? Oh, gosh. Got the double guns from Katie. Now watch this. My crew guy, Dennis. Oh, man. That was so sick. We talked about doing the Top Gun thing, and he did it. Just send me off. Will she make the show? Yes, yes, yes. No, 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 no. Aggressive off the starting line. Drove into spokes. 60 foot was great. They will leave here a little bit on the I thought for sure by the time I got to the 60 foot cone, I'm like, it's hooked up. We're going for it. Still looking shiny. Got a little bit further, and I felt the car literally lift up, and I was smoking the tires. And within that moment, my heart sank for my team because we couldn't get into the show. But At this moment, I'm going down the track. I'm undoing my belts. I'm slowing down so I can make the turn off the top end of the track. Now, these moments where it's literally I see my crew guy Dennis send me off, I don't see anyone, I don't talk to anyone, I don't hear anyone until I turn off the track, because I actually don't have a radio in my car. So everything I do, I have no clue until someone comes over with a time slip and lets me know what happened. But in this moment, I knew by the 60 foot, it was going pretty fast. And I knew the second it blew the tires off that we just had a little too much in the clutch for it. But you gotta, like, let me take you back a little bit. We had to make a decision. So the decision was I can either go out there and keep the clutch the same and run a 395 and still not get in. Or I could have gone out there, changed the clutch a little bit to where we think that we can get down the track and run a 385 and get in the show and make a really good run for the car. So obviously I chose the latter. I really wanted to try and get down the track because what am I gonna learn off a 395 run? I've already done 395. The car's done 395. It's nothing new for the parts. It was that 385 that we were going for, but it just did not hook up. But it's still so cool. I mean, even sitting here watching myself do this, it's kind of like I'm like on this out of body experience, and I'm like watching my grandpa or watching my dad or watching any of these people that drive top fuel, not me. And the realness is the actual memory I have of driving the car. It's so mind-boggling what we get to do, what we get to experience right here on Earth at NHRA drag racing. That is so beyond unbelievable that you just have to experience it. But man, and you know what the sucky part is that I'm super proud of my team. And I'm super proud that we were able to keep everything in line, and all the hard work that we did pay off. It just didn't pay off on paper. But I have to wait like 6 more weeks to do this again. The troubles of having a part-time team. But this just sunk the hook in deeper. I am going down the right path. I am making the right decisions, and that 379 run is coming. It absolutely is. And I think we might be able to do it at the Lucas Oil Nationals in Brainerd next. Whew, man. Is your heart racing like mine is right now? I feel like I just got out of the car. Oh, I love it so much. But thank you to all of you for watching and following me around the racetrack. The next few weeks, I'll be hanging out with Paul Lee on the Western Swing, so we'll have some cool behind-the-scenes footage on that. Is there something you want to ask your favorite driver? Is there something you want to see in Denver and Sonoma? Why don't you comment it below, and I will try my hardest to accomplish those questions. But until then, happy 4th of July. Fast cars and freedom, that's what we live for, right, guys? And I will see you guys on the flip side.